the illusion that people have is that we can prolong life almost in any situation, and that the key to prolonging life is more treatment. So people say, oh, you know, do everything you can, don't give up, you know, keep giving him the chemo, if he rests, we'll resuscitate him, assuming that that will actually prolong people's lives. I don't really think mostly it does. It does bring a lot of suffering. And what they then, on the corresponding side, kind of tend to think is, and palliative care will mean shortening life. Now, there are some recent studies, one from the New England Journal in lung cancer that everybody knows about, but that actually show that apparently palliative care prolongs life. And I'm not surprised, because what I see is patients who transfer to palliative care, their quality of life improves, they start to feel better in themselves, they start to do better, and that's probably better for everything, and they probably live longer. I certainly don't think that, you see, people have this illusion that medicine can do anything. It can't. I mean, it can do some things, but it's relatively limited, surprisingly, in terms of prolonging the life of somebody with a serious disease. And so I don't think that the choice is kind of black and white, you know, medical intervention to prolong life or quality of life. I think often focusing on quality of life, you're not giving up. You may think you are, but you're probably not giving up as much as, at least as much as families often think they are.